Marta Romero.
And I'm Esmeralda Frias, and we're here in the Religion Department to present to you our presentation about family domestic violence here in Fort Worth area.
Today, we're going to talk about statistics, numbers, and several cases that have been involved in domestic violence in our area of Fort Worth. We're going to interview scholar people that work in TCU, as well as personnel that can let us know ways and places where we can seek help. Our first interview for today, it's going to be with Joretta Marshall, Executive Vice President, Professor of Pastoral Theology, Care and Counseling, and Dean of the Bright Divinity School at TCU.
So family violence is a problem, and it destroys families and individual lives. One would hope that in Fort Worth there are enough resources for women and men and children, particularly the most vulnerable in family violence, to find ways to address issues and situations. What we know is that family violence happens a lot, and it happens way too much, and that the church, in particular, doesn't always know how to address issues of family violence. So they often tend to get in the way rather than be helpful. And one of the things that I try to do in teaching future pastors is to help them think about how do you help persons who are experiencing family violence to find the right kind of professional resources that will assist them and get them out of danger, out of harm's way.
Upon a time there was a girl. In her early years she had to learn.
Now we're going to show you pictures and graphs that represent domestic violence here in the Fort Worth area. We're here at the TCU campus interviewing TCU students, asking them what they know about domestic violence and if they're aware of the situations that occur here in the Fort Worth area. What is your awareness about family domestic violence that happens here in Fort Worth?
I'm not for sure how often it happens. I'm sure the number's a lot higher than people really expect, but I have no clue.
Do you think because they don't like show it on TV as much?
Definitely. People just assume everyone's like happy and it's not happening when it's getting hidden, or people just don't really like think that's really domestic violence when a lot of things could be domestic violence.
I guess you can understand why people don't like to talk about domestic violence, because it's hard. Me personally, my aunt was hit by my uncle many times. It's a really hard topic to talk about because not only she gets hurt.
So I'm here at the Safe Herring of Tarrant County. I'm here with April Harris, and she is the Vice President of Development.
How does the Safe Haven help the community in Tarrant County?
Well, we serve mostly Tarrant County, but we also serve other counties in the region. There aren't a lot of domestic violence shelters that are equipped to handle as many people as we are. Mm-hmm. But we provide services through safety, which is our shelter system. We have one in Fort Worth and one in Arlington. There they receive food, shelter, clothes. All they have is what they came in with on their backs. Counseling for both themselves and their children, case management, and legal services while they're in the shelters. We also have two resource centers, we call them. They're off-site places where people can go access counseling services for themselves, for their children. Immigration services are a real big issue right now, is helping people with their immigration status, so yeah. Legal services there.
What do you think it will take to end domestic violence?
I think a lot of education early on, which I didn't mention before, but that's another service that we provide. We see about 40,000 people a year until people are really, really understand how this happens, that it happens everywhere. Mm-hmm. that someone they know has probably been, affected or a victim of domestic violence at some point in their life. What red flags to look for as teenagers? A lot of times being drawn towards that type of relationship, the only way that this is going to end is if we stop asking the question, why does she stay? And we start asking the question as a community, as a society, that we start asking the question, what happened along the way that made it okay to him to hurt her in whatever way he had?